How are you, my dear students? Hope you all are good. Today we are going to discuss the topic that is electric current, that is from the chapter that is electricity. Today we will cover the entire topic of electric current, that what is electric current, how can the electric current can be measured, and the last topic that we have to discuss is that the measuring instrument of electric current, that how can the electric current can be measured. Okay, so that measuring instrument, that is we will discuss, and why does that measuring instrument will be utilized, and how the connection will be provided, that we have to know. So today so now we are going to discuss for that topic. So as you know that the flowing water constitute the water current in the rivers. Similarly, if water is flowing in the rivers, it means that water current is flowing. And if the electric charge flows through a cross section of conductor, then we can say that the current is flowing through that circuit. What does it mean? It means that if we have a particular cross section of conductor, and from that particular cross section of conductor some amount of electric charges are flowing, then if some amount of electric charges are flowing, then we can say that electric current is flowing through the circuit. It has some practical advantages as well, like as we know that in the case of a torch, that the cells or the battery, suppose that the cells or the battery when placed in proper order, then it will provide the flow of charges or an electric current to the torch bulb, which cause the torch bulb to glow. It means that in the case of the torch, we have an instrument, and that instrument is called the switch. A switch acts as a conducting link, that is it has a conducting link between the cell and the bulb. Thereby here two symbols are utilized. You can see that here I had utilized the first symbol of electric switch. Okay, that is in the position first, the first one is in the position of off position, and the second one is in the on position. That is the first one that we are seeing, that the first one is in open circuited and the second one is in the closed circuited. Now we have the plug key. Here you can see that two plug keys and the two notations of plug keys are utilized. The first one is open circuited and the second one is the closed circuited. Now the next thing that we have to understand, that what is electricity? We are saying that the flow of charges in an electric circuit constitutes the electricity. The next thing is the electric current, as the rate of flow of charges in an electric circuit is called the electric current, and thereby we can write that current is equal to charge upon time. And suppose that we have a cross section of conductor. Here you can see that we are utilizing a cross section of conductor, and if from that cross section of conductor q amount of charges are flowing, then if q amount of charges are flowing in t seconds, then the particular amount of current is I equals to q upon t. And if we have to derive the SI unit for electric current, then we can easily derive that, like electric current is equals to charge upon time. So we can write that if it is charged upon time, then the SI unit of charge is coulomb, as we know from the Coulomb's law, and the SI unit of time is second. That's why we can write that the SI unit of electric current is ampere. Okay, because coulomb per second is the result that is given by Andrew Marie Ampere. That's why we can write that the SI unit of electric current is ampere. Electric current, as we know, that it is a tensor quantity because it does not obey the triangle law of vector addition, and its SI unit is ampere, which is denoted by A. And suppose that we have to define 1 ampere, then we can easily define that 1 ampere. Like 1 ampere is defined when 1 coulomb of charge is flowing through a cross section of conductor for 1 second. So if 1 coulomb of charge is flowing through a cross section of conductor for 1 second, then we can say that the particular amount of electric current is of 1 ampere. The next thing that we have to understand is the direction of electric current in an electric circuit. So suppose that we have an electric circuit which is made from the metallic wires, then as we know that electrons constitutes the flow of charges. The charges are flowing just because the flow of electrons, But when the electricity was discovered, the electrons were not known at that time. So when the phenomena of electricity was observed, then only positive charges were known, and that's why we are taking the direction of electric current is from the positive terminal of the battery to the negative terminal, because when the charges were discovered, then only positive charges were known. And that's why we can write that the direction of electric current is from positive terminal of the cell or the battery to the negative terminal. Now we have a measuring instrument also, and that measuring instrument is the ammeter. Here you can see that there is a symbol of ammeter here in the on one of its side is it is written the plus sign, and the second and the other side is of negative sign. So there is a positive terminal as well as negative terminal associated with the ammeter. Thereby, the next thing is that connection of ammeter. Suppose that we have an ammeter to measure the electric current. Suppose that a particular amount of current, that is 5 ampere, is to be measured. Then that can be measured by an instrument, that is ammeter. So there is a connection, and the connection is that ammeter is always connected in series, because to obtain the same value of electric current flowing through the circuit. So as we have to obtain the same value of electric current flowing through the circuit, that's why the ammeter is always connected in series. So that is all the things related to the electric current. Thereby, the next topic that we have to discuss is the electric potential and the electric potential difference. So we will discuss that in the next session that we